You can click on All Services and you will find the Management Groups or directly from the launcher, your favorites. So you can create Management Group hierarchy to group the different subscriptions. So you click on Add Management Group and this is where you will create the different groups, or you can link to an existing one if you want to build a hierarchy. So what I've done here so far, I've got a dev and a hub and spoke management groups, and you see below the spoke, I put my subscription. So let's go to the policy. And in the policy, in the overview, you can see the overall policies that are applied to your subscriptions. You can see here I'm 100% compliant. The get started is a good way to be able to start with policies. So let's view the definitions first. In the definitions, you can see that you got a built-in library of policies that are coming out of the box. And they are all open source available on the GitHub, so they will grow over time. Some are in preview, some are not. You got categories as well, when you can filter the policies you want to review. You can also search for a custom policy. So I've got one created here called Deny Public IP Address. And if you explore the content of the policy, you can see the effect is a denied. And here I've got the different rules. So I don't want to be able to apply a public IP to an existing nick, and I don't want to put a new public IP. So let's see how we can assign the policy. So when you go to the assign policy, you can assign the policy either to the management groups or directly to a resource group in your subscription. Because we want to drive policy and leveraging management group, the best way is to apply it to the spoke. So I click on the spoke. And now I'm saying this policy will be assigned to the spoke. You can also use the initiative, which is a set of policies that you can apply to a resource. So for example, here you've got the OMS extension, so you want to monitor a virtual machine or a virtual machine scale set. So you can Yeah, you can explore, for example, the monitoring of the VM scale set, and you can see you got different set of policies that you want to evaluate. So some of them can be deployed if they does not exist, or you can just decide to trigger an audit to inform that this extension has not been installed. So you got exactly the same approach. So it's a JSON definition when you define all the criteria. So here you got the image, and if it is not the deployment is not done, then you can include the ARM template deployment with all the parameters to add the extension to the virtual machine. So if I scroll down, you will see all the parameters.